Hey everybody, my name is Chris. Welcome to Casual Fragrances. Hope you're having a great day. Today I'm here with Steven.
Hey everyone.
I'd like to thank Steven for letting me have the opportunity to do a video in his cool studio.
Thank you.
It's cool and it's a dream come true. Today we're talking about fragrances from the House of Christian Dior. We're doing a fragrance battle video with all the Dior Sauvage fragrances, and there's a giveaway attached to it as well. So before the video starts, the giveaway is pretty simple. Make sure you subscribe to Steven's channel, Reddit Lessons. I'm going to leave his channel down below.
Thank you.
Make sure you like this video and make sure you click the subscribe button for my channel as well. And we're going to give away a sample of the new Elixir.
Official carded sample.
Oh, definitely. That's awesome. So definitely just follow the rules. I'll leave it down below in the comment section too so you guys understand it. And I'll pick the winner in 1 week's time. I'll announce the winner in my full review of Dior Sauvage Elixir. In this video here, I'm going to break down each one with Steven, and we're going to give our favorites from first to last. At the end of the day, whatever one you like, that's fine. We're not telling you which one to buy. We're just giving you recommendations at the end of the day. We're going to start off with the EDT. This one's been out the longest.
Yeah.
It's fresh. It's clean.
Thank you.
Bergamot. Some people might call it a shower gel fragrance or Ambroxan Balm. At the end of the day, it's fresh and clean, and it will garner you compliments at the end of the day.
I think the first time I smelled it, I thought it was pretty simple. Nothing too fancy, no bells and whistles. But actually, the more time I spend with it, the more I realize that it has the black pepper, it has the Ambroxan, it has the bergamot, it has some of those other intricacies in the heart. And so it's not as simple as some people think initially. So I like this one because it's very fresh, perfect for the office. If you're just on the go, you're looking for something that's going to fit the bill, I think the Eau de Toilette is perfect.
I think it's something that you can just pick up and spray and go, a casual scent. Now, some people might say, okay, it's a blue freshie. But at the end of the day, ladies and gentlemen, men and women like blue and fresh fragrances. You know you're not going to be offensive. You know you're going to smell fresh and clean. Some people might say shower gel-ish, whatever. But you know in your heart that you're going to smell nice today, and you might garner some compliments. And you don't have to be stressing out wearing a fragrance that you love but somebody else might not like, or get any type of looks like, why are you wearing that fragrance in public? So
absolutely,
you know, and the price is not bad. I think it's around still, I think it's $80. Before it was $77. It went up literally $3 now more. But it's $80 for a 60ml bottle of this, and 100ml bottle is $100.
Okay.
So I'll leave the links down below to Nordstrom, Sephora, and Dior, where you can do your research and buy the size appropriate for you. I'll talk about the Parfum. So this one here is not my bottle. It's Steven's bottle. So I'm going to let him break down a little bit and give you my opinion after he gives his opinion.
Thank you, Chris. Now, of course, the one that's missing here is the Eau de Parfum. I do apologize. I actually have that fragrance in Studio B, so it's not within access, but obviously I think we both done a video on it. We both know what it's all about.
I'll leave the video down below for his and my channel. You can click on the link, but it's a nice fragrance.
Perfect.
It's fresh. It's dark, but we're going to move on to the next one, you know.
Step up from the previous two. And this one has a similar freshness as the original. I know a lot of people talk about the Eau de Toilette kind of has this metallic vibe in the opening. I personally enjoy it. I think some other people find it to be a little bit too screechy, a little bit too harsh, like nails on a chalkboard. I don't get that per se, but I can totally understand where people are coming from. This one has more of those ambery tones in the base, and so it's a little bit deeper, it's a little warmer, a little more fulfilling even, if I can use that adjective. And so this comes across as a more mature version of Dior Sauvage EDT. So this one is the businessman, closing deals, corporate meetings, running around. The Eau de Parfum is more like that same businessman in the evening, hitting up his favorite watering hole, taking off his tie a little bit, ordering a scotch on the rocks, like, you know, unwinding for the evening. So this one has a little bit more of a grown-up feel, if you will. And so that would be the best way for me to compare these two and maybe paint a picture of what the differences are.
I like that one as well. My issue, I said in my video, when I did my video back in the day, I couldn't smell it after a few minutes. And pretty much, I taught Steven about this off camera, I go nose blind to it. So I don't smell it after the first 5 or 10 minutes. My girlfriend Kelly can smell it all day. She's like, Chris, you did 3 sprays. It's loud. I can smell it. So basically, it's just I can't smell it after 10 minutes. I go to nosmic to it. I can't smell it, but she can smell it on me all day. So will I ever buy a bottle? Maybe just to collect them, but I'm never going to really wear because I can't smell it. So
absolutely. And that's a good point. I think that that's a conundrum for a lot of consumers. Like, okay, now there are 4 varieties on the market. do I need all four? Do I need two out of the four? Can I just get one? And so I think in this case, maybe we can sort of dial it back down to just one of them, right?
Oh, yeah, yeah. Definitely, you don't need all four of them. And by the end of the video, I'm going to tell you what two I like. And maybe Steven will give his two favorite he would suggest you should get. Or maybe one out of all four. You don't need all four of them.
Sure. So the last one, obviously, this is Chris's bottle. I don't have a bottle of it yet. I did my first impressions off the carded sample. This one, of course, is the brand new 2021 Sauvage Elixir.
Yeah, so this is the new one, like he talked about already. I did a first impression. I'll leave my video up here or down below. This fragrance here, okay. So there's a freshness about it, but it's not an overall freshy like the other ones. There's a darkness to this fragrance. There's, if I recall, there's cinnamon, there's nutmeg in this fragrance, there's lavender in this fragrance as well, and you get that in the fragrance. It's not overly sweet, I wouldn't say that, but lavender comes in the forefront in this fragrance as well. There's some spices in this fragrance, which is nice as well. It's well balanced. It's a little bit come off a darker scent where I would feel like I would wear it more in the fall and winter, but at the end of the day, it's your Sauvage. You can wear this all year round if you want. Be careful with the sprays because you only need maybe max two sprays. Anything more, it fills up a room. I did my mistake by spraying five times. So I'm just letting you know, just be careful with your sprays.
Yeah, it's interesting what Chris said, because I was working off of the small carded sample, which we're giving away. But even that, just a few sprays, like I noticed it. And like Chris said, there's a preponderance of spices in here. So the nutmeg and the cinnamon. And, you know, that's kind of what reminded me of a lot of these 80s powerhouse fragrances without the fir balsam or the oak moss or something like that. Although, realistically speaking, that might actually be in here. But I think the note that's really bringing me back to the 80s is the lavender. So the lavender, the spices kind of giving off this barbershop fougere vibe. And I think it's really the darkest one of all of them, and I think it's the most mature one. Now, mature without being dated, because I think when you think dated, you think, oh, okay, this is not relevant anymore, or this was only appropriate or in style in decades past. I don't think that that's necessarily the case here. I think you can still wear Sauvage Elixir. Obviously, it just came out, but I think it's totally appropriate in the year 2021. It just happens to be a little bit more on the rugged side, a little bit more on the mature side. Definitely a formal vibe, in my opinion. Definitely conveys a sense of sophistication.
Yeah, Steven wrapped it up perfectly. I like it a lot. My girlfriend Kelly likes it. I had a sample like he did, so I've worn it a few times for my sample, and then I realized Kelly liked it, so it's already a number one winner. I do like Dior fragrances, so yes, I will be a little bit biased to most people with Dior fragrances. I do like it, and, you know, is the price worthy of the purchase? That's going to maintain you as a person if you can afford that price, because there are different prices. So if you can't afford a new one, they do have the EDT, the EDP, and they have the Parfum. So prices are going to go different ranges for the fragrances, so definitely spray them on your skin and see which one you like.
Yeah, and ultimately, I think it depends on your personal sentiments, your occupation, what kind of scenario you're going to find yourself wearing these in. So if you're just looking for something very bright, upbeat, casual, maybe you're a young professional, the Eau de Toilette is really where it's at. If you're looking for something that's a little bit more dialed back in terms of that bright freshness, something a little bit more mature, obviously you're going to go with the Eau de Parfum. And Elixir is the one where you really want to execute that boss CEO status, in my opinion. You know, no frills, no games, just pure class, pure sophistication. Elixir is really where it's at. Obviously, the most cost efficient one is the Eau de Toilette. That's the one that's going to give you, in my opinion, the most bang for your buck. I know, of course, a lot of people talk about reformulations as well, and some people have been like, oh, the Eau de Toilette is not worth it anymore. I don't know. I actually ran through a few bottles of the Eau de Toilette, and I purchased one within the past year, year and a half-ish, and it still smells good. Like, I get good performance from it. It's who you are as a person, what your personal tastes are, and it's kind of hard to pick a favorite, right?
It is hard. I mean, it's one of those things where it's like anyone you go with, you're going to wear Dior Sauvage. Yeah. You're going to go places, and these are going to be complimentary fragrances. Now, the Elixir might be a little bit different to get a compliment on, but I feel like the EDT, the EDP, and the Parfum, people are going to like it. You are bound to get compliments. I'm not saying you buy this, you get compliments tomorrow. I'm saying is you're going to buy the fragrance, and people are going to like the way you smell, and you should get a compliment. You're going to feel confident wearing a fragrance, and it's going to perform. It's hard to have a favorite. I mean, at the end of the day, people have asked me, so I will say, if I can only own one, it would be the EDT. That started. If it wasn't for the EDT, you would not have these slankers. That's the easy answer right there, but everybody's going to have their favorite.
Me too. Actually, my favorite is the EDT. That is the one that will get you the most compliments if that's what you're in it for. If you're looking for, or my second favorite, I should say, is probably Elixir, just because if I want to wear something different from the EDT, I'm not going to go with the EDP or the Parfum because I feel like those are still in Sauvage territory. So I'll probably pick this one as my second favorite, and then maybe the Eau de Parfum just because of the price differential. But I do want to address something that people have been saying online, which is that this one could have been its own fragrance. A lot of people are saying, you know what, Elixir could have been a totally different fragrance, doesn't smell too similar to the Sauvage lineup, which I totally respect. But of course, you know, with a brand like Dior, Sauvage is doing really well. It's the best seller on the market right now on the designer men's side. So, you know, I definitely applaud Dior. Kudos to them for putting out a product that has managed to reach the homes and the wallets of so many people.
Definitely. That's hit my wallet too. So,
me too.
You know, it is what it is. But yeah, they're all great. And I think you should definitely, gentlemen, go to your local Sephora, Nordstrom, or Saks, and go there, spray them on your skin because they have them available, and see which one you prefer. You like, you may not like all of them, you may only like one or two of them. You know, we're just giving you our recommendations at the end of the day, and we hope you consider buying one. I hope you enjoy the fragrance at the end of the day. I thank you guys for watching another video. I thank Steven for letting me be in his beautiful studio and making another fragrance video and talking about Dior Sauvage, which Dior is one of my favorite brands. So thank you so much, Steven. I appreciate it.
Anytime. You're always welcome.
If you guys like your Sauvage fragrances, what's your favorite out of these? Plus the Eau de Parfum, which we don't have. We are sorry about that. But let me know what your favorite Dior Sauvage is down below. And I will pick a giveaway winner in about 1 week when I do my full in-depth review on Dior Sauvage Elixir. Thank you guys for watching. I'll see you guys next video. Be safe. Peace.
Bye.